didn't have this day. I'm gonna tell y'all a secret. I'm not a member of the youth praise team, okay? I know that's hard to believe, but we're gonna go on anyway, amen? All right, who came to give God praise this morning? Man, let's give God praise. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. I will rejoice. Y'all know this, sing with me. This is the day. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day. This is the day that the Lord has made. Now we're gonna say thank you for the day. Thank you for the day. Thank you for the day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it. This is the day, I will rejoice and be glad in it. I will enter his gates with thanksgiving in my heart. I will enter his courts with praise. I will say this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. This is the day. This is the day that the Lord has made. That the Lord, let me hear you sing, I will rejoice. We serve an awesome God.
Amen.
God is so amazing.
Amen.
He's so amazing. Hallelujah. That's why we worship him. We love him. Amen. Because he loves us. He shows us what love is.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. We're grateful for that. Amen. If you know the song, sing.
My hallelujah belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to you.
You deserve it.
You deserve it.
Just wanna praise you forever and ever.
blessings and glory and honor, they all belong to you. Thank you, Jesus, for blessing me.
Just wanna praise you
forever,
forever,
and ever,
and ever.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How is everyone this morning? Everybody doing good?
Yes.
Highly favored. Almost time to send the kids back to school. I'm sure we spent this past weekend and making sure everything was ready. Clothes and notebooks and pencils and papers and all those good things. Must be nice to yet have a kid that you can shop for school. Anybody, did you enjoy that? Those of us who don't have those kids no more? What you say, no? It was a big thing to get the kid ready for school. It was a big thing. But God was good. He always provided.
Amen.
And I'm sure he is doing the same for you this morning. Isn't it good to yet be amongst the living? Wake up and you realize that things are well with you and still get around, if no more than about a little bit. Anymore, I don't take anything for granted.
Amen.
David Huffman laughed at me and asked me what was wrong the other Wednesday when I got up and knee gave out on me. And I said, well, it's that time of life. I'm glad that I got a knee that can give out. And I can feel it giving out. You know, I'm serious. I don't take things for granted. anymore. And let me tell you something. The young is dying just as well as the old. Young people, this is our youth Sunday. Young people ought to get up every morning and say, Lord, I thank you for another day. When they come back home and getting ready to go to bed for the night, young people ought to say, Lord, I thank you that I made it through another day. I say to our young people, trust me, don't take nothing for granted. It doesn't matter that you can run a 4-2, 4-3, 4-4, 40, shoot a tray with ease, a ballet move, or hit a softball, stand in front of a group and debate, or is excellent in your studies. That's just God's gift to you. But he gives you another gift, and that's life. And you ought to thank him. And I hope our parents are teaching our kids this. You know, I don't care that I'm in preschool. Mom, Dad ought to be teaching me to give thanks to God for his gifts. Don't make them believe that you're doing everything for them, because there are some things you can't do for them. God has to help. He has to assist. So even these little babies here ought to be taught. Give thanks for God's gift. If it's a morning, if it's an evening, give thanks to God for his gifts. Because he does not have to bless us that way. So I hope that that is happening. But I'm just grateful to God for another Sunday morning. And I'm not going to be up here long before you. I've been trying to chastise myself for taking so long doing these call to worship. But sometimes things just move you.
Amen. Amen.
And you can't do it in a hurry. You all pray with me on that. You can't do it in a hurry. Sometime you want to take a little time and say, Lord, I thank you. Sometimes you want to share what the Lord has done for you. Marky, James, and I can sit for 2 hours and watch a football game. I ain't going to get mad if I do 30 minutes. Our kids can stay on these cell phones and these video games for hour after hour after hour. Don't get mad at me if I go a little long in call to worship. Because I know how good God is. And I know that I want to thank him for how good he has been. And not only has been, but how good he is. And let's go even further. How good he has promised to be to us. Yeah. I can so well remember when I was young. Sometime I laughed at the aches and pains of the old. Oh, you just getting old. But it sure is good to get old. Because the other side of the fence ain't too good. It's good. And I thank God for that. My young people, give me the oath right quick. Now, don't no adult tell them. Give me the oath right quick.
Lord, I am confident that you want to have this
I hope that's your prayer every morning. I'm confident it's not a prayer per se. It's a statement of confidence, a statement of determination. I know is what you're saying, that nothing's going to happen today that you and I together cannot handle. The devil ain't big enough. I want you all to hear me. The devil ain't big enough to whip me and God. He ain't big enough. He ain't bad enough. He ain't tough enough. He ain't got enough in his arsenal to beat me and God together. Now, I'm smart enough to know that he can whoop me all over the place. But when God joins me, and we put those two powers, yes, I do have power now because the Lord gives me power. When we put those two powers together, there is nothing the devil can do to defeat you. Therefore, because there's something else you got to do with that. Therefore, I will, in all my ways. In other words, I'm just simply saying, Lord, in order for you and I to handle this devil today, I'm going to yield to you. Now, some parents should have shouted right there. Because when the kid yields to God, that means his decisions are no longer his decision. That means that his way is not no longer his way. That means that he has finally come to realize something. I'm not smart enough to do this by myself. I submit to you. I give everything to you. I give up to you. Because I ain't smart enough. Oh, I'm 4.2. And that's great. When they said that of Jeremiah for the pageant, I'm going, whoa, I would have loved a 2.2. And here he's off the chart. Yeah. That's a blessing. Somebody has done some work. And Jeremiah has yielded to that in order to make that kind of accomplishment. But still yet, without God, I'm just not smart enough. Adults, anybody ever got in his own way? Yes, sir. Do I need to say that a little different? Anybody ever got in the way and messed up your own life? I hope you shared that with your kids. I hope you said, I got in my way, my own way.
Yes, sir.
And I messed up my thing.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But thank God, I got smart one day. And I said, Lord, I'm tired of trying to determine this myself. I woke up to that song that Roshika was, I don't sleep. I give my heart, open up my heart to you. Tara sings it even. Matter of fact, she sung it on an anniversary as a salute to me, and I really appreciate that. I really, for the first time this morning, listened to that song. The person has finally come to realize it ain't working.
Yeah.
It ain't gonna work.
Yes, sir.
I'm tired of it.
Yeah.
And so I'm opening up to you.
Yeah.
For your directions. I don't want to keep making the same mistake over and over again. You know, that's something to stand before God and say, I'm tired of making mistakes. And I don't want to make the same mistake. Some of us keep going the same old way, the same old way, the same old way, over and over again. Let's teach our children. Let God direct it. Come on, Tari, give me a verse of it. Because when I heard it this morning, I said, I'm calling California. And I'm going to say to my grandson, open up your heart to God. Meditate on this just for a second. And I'm not going to be long before you. Keep meditating with me. Thank you, Tara, Dave, thanks. And I hope our young people heard where she said, I don't want to disappoint you. God is so good, so powerful, so loving. I didn't want to, there were some things I didn't do because I didn't want to disappoint my daddy. I didn't want to hurt him. So I wanted to do them now, but I was afraid of disappointing him. He had such high hopes and expectations of me. I was scared of dope because all I could see was the Tulsa World saying, preacher's son. And I ran because I didn't want to hurt my daddy that way. Now, if I'm that way with my earthly father, think how I am with my heavenly father. So young people, just be mindful. Life is just beginning for you. God is setting it up for you right now. You don't have life right now. Your life is being molded. Your life is being shaped. Your life is being established right now. What God has for you is ahead of you. Don't disappoint him. You can still have fun. You can still be popular. You can still do some things and not disappoint God. But if it comes to a choice between honoring God and disappointing God, hey, just say, I can't do this. You ain't got to tell nobody else. Just say, I can't do this. Sometimes you got to play dumb so you can maintain your status quo. Sometimes you got to just play like you're dumb. But you're really saying, that ain't, I don't do that. Sometimes you got to come up with that little catchy phrase. Nah, man, I'm all right just now. I'm okay. Play dumb. Sometimes you need to play dumb to get you through the moment. And they don't know no difference either. They don't know no difference. Oh, man, he sure is cool, man. He sure is. Your blessings are ahead of you. Thank you for coming this morning. Again, I never take our coming for granted. Because you could have chosen to do anything this morning but come here. But you are here to be blessed and to be a blessing. Amen. To be refreshed where you can fight again. Because the world still needs your efforts.
Morning again, church family. I have to say thank you to Miss Tara and Brother David. That is a moving testament to what we should be about. Opening up our heart so God can come in and do what he knows how to do. Just like Reverend Williams was telling us, bring that out of us so we know what we need to do. It's not a secret. It's there. And we just know how to pull it out and work it for us. But that's not what I'm here for. I just had to say that. I appreciate both of you. This is a time in our service that we recognize our visitors. If there are any visitors here this morning visiting with us, would you please stand and continue to stand as we offer this welcome? Are there any visitors? Would you please stand? Just in case, on behalf of our pastor and our entire church family, we do welcome you this morning. We hope something is said or done that will continue on your Christian journey. Please do come again.
Church, let's stand and welcome each other. The Jesus in me, love the Jesus in you.
Jesus in you, so easy.
go up, blessings come down. Praises go up, blessings come down. So easy. So easy. So easy. Easy love. If I be lifted up, I'll draw men unto me. If I be lifted up, that'll draw men unto me. So easy. So easy. So easy. Easy to love. Jesus, see me. Love Jesus, see you.
I am a seed. Thank you. Let's give our children another hand. I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praises shall continually, ongoing, perpetually be in my mouth. Amen. What an honor and pleasure it is to be back in the house of the Lord and just to be back home. Thank God for all your prayers that was sent down to Alabama while I was there. It was definitely a trying experience. But Mac Fannin and Whitehead said, ain't no stopping us now. We're on the move. Another version says, I don't feel no ways tired. I come too far from where I started from. And nobody told me that the road would be easy. I've come too far. Thank God for the church and to the pastor for another opportunity to come before you today. I'm just taking it all in.
Yeah, take your time. Take your time.
But there is a word from God today from the New Testament of turn your Bibles and your phones to 1 Peter chapter 5. 1 Peter chapter 5. 1 Peter chapter 5, starting at verse 5 through 7. I'm going to read from the Message translation this morning. When you're there, say amen. If you need some more time, say wait for me. All right, we're all there. Verse 5 says, and you who are younger must follow your leaders. But all of you leaders and followers alike are to be down to earth with each other. For God has had it with the proud, but takes delight in just plain people. So be content with who you are and don't put up the airs. God's strong hand is on you. He'll promote you at the right time. Live carefree before God. He is most careful with you. I like it in the New Revised Standard Version as well. It says, verse 7 says, cast all your anxieties on him because he cares for you. He cares for you. Let us pray. Loving Spirit, we thank you this day that you've given us. One more chance, Lord, another opportunity to give you everything that we got. All the praise and all the worship goes to you. Lord, we're here today expecting you to do everything that you said you will do. So we ask that you open up our ears, our hearts, and our minds that we may hear what you have to say to your people. Hide me behind your cross, Lord, as we search through your word today. In Jesus Christ's name, we pray. Amen. I know I haven't been here in a while, but it's so good to see a new face on the drums. You know, I got love for the drummers. I got love for the drummers. Love for the drummers. You often hear me talk about my childhood experiences and my teenage years in church. That is because, for the most part, I did enjoy them. As a child, I had a lot of fun. As teenagers, I had even much more fun. You will get in trouble, but that's all about growing up. I love going outside because I didn't stay inside and play video games all day. I love having no bills, but the truth be told, I didn't know what a bill was. Hello. But then it was those times when I did not like my childhood. And majority of those times is when my mother made me go to church. Listen to me. She made me go to church. It was never, do you want to go? Because that means that you have an option. That means you can say yes or no. But where I grew up, it was not, do you want to go to choir rehearsal? Do you want to go to church? It's get up and let's go. But I went to church and I heard a lot of songs. Songs that didn't have a lot of meaning to me at that time, probably just like you today. A lot of these songs that you hear don't have a lot of meaning. But when you grow up, you'll learn that a lot of these old songs that you hear traveling through your ear, navigating through your body, will come back home, and you will realize that those old songs had some meaning. And I remember, as a young person, I heard trouble don't last always. And that's what I want to talk to you about this morning, when the road gets rough. When the road gets rough. Believe it or not, young people, everyone in this building will have some rough times. And I thank God for that song, because the storm is now passing over some of my rough times. But everyone in this sanctuary is either coming out of some rough times, headed to some rough times, or some of y'all in some mess right now. But the good news is, it won't last always. In this passage, Peter gets with us and teaches us how to deal with some rough times. And he teaches us humility, suffering, but he also extends glory to us. Anybody can be a Christian when the sun is shining, but can you stand the rain? It don't take much faith to give God glory when all of your bills are paid. You don't have to be real strong and shout hallelujah when everything well is going in your life. You don't have to be real strong and when you're getting all these A's and B's and you're graduating and you're doing everything you're supposed to do, when you pass the test and when you have quizzes. It's cool when your teacher likes you. But when the bottom falls out, when sickness comes and when your car won't start and when you don't have no food on your table, when you don't have new clothes for the first day of school, when you don't have the newest shoes when you go to school year, when your girlfriend don't want to be with you this year, or when your boyfriend said this is a new year, when you get blocked on social media for the other members, when your health starts to decline, when your children break your heart, when tough times come, it's when your faith kicks in and you know he is a present help in the time of trouble. Young people, you will have some rough times, and I'm here to tell you that you're going to need some multiple places to find your sanctuary. And your sanctuary don't always have to be in Antioch, because you're not going to always be in Antioch. You're not going to always be surrounded by the saints and Christians in this today. Today, you need to find your sanctuary in your classroom. You need to find a sanctuary in your own home, a secret place where you can call on the Lord when you are dealing with your rough times in your life. Today, you young persons and young people that are doing some tough times, some of y'all can't even see some of the tough times as these young people are going through. They're smiling just to keep from laughing. And I had a young person in this church a couple of months ago, right before I left, said, "I'm here just because. I don't believe nothing about what's going on in here." He said, "I'm going through some rough times right now, and I can't see my way through." You come into church, young people, with all these aches and pains, not just the young people. You singing in the choir, you're teaching Sunday school, you're reading the Bible, but you are still going through some rough times. Well, I have some good news for you this morning. I got some bad news for you too. Which one you want first? The bad news is it won't get easier, but it's going to get rougher. And it might take you just a little bit longer just to get out. But the good news is he'll show up and get you through your rough times. And just because he hasn't shown up now does not mean that he won't show up. The Lord will make a way somehow. Somebody in here can help me and say, "I've been down to my last dime. I never thought I would have made it, but I stepped back and looked over my life." Now, young people, you've heard it, all these cliches, you know, he'll come through when you want him. You heard if you take one step, he'll take two. You heard he'll make a way out of no way and he'll dry your tears. I believe it. Yeah, I'm with you. Provide you through all these rough times, but you got to have just a little bit of faith during all of these rough times. So listen to this. Faith must confirm what it cannot prove during these rough times. You might want to write that one down. Faith must confirm what it cannot prove during these rough times. I can't prove there is a God. I knew I wasn't going to get too many amens. I cannot prove there is a God, but I've got some evidence. I can't prove the existence, but I have some evidence. I cannot prove that he sits high and looks low, but I'm looking at some evidence on the outside. I've experienced some things, young people, that helped me understand that not what I didn't know now, what I didn't know then, I know now. My experience confirms that during my rough moments, if it had not been for God on my side, there's some people in here that can testify. I wish I can break out to a testimony moment, but I'm not going to do that. But I know they can testify that I've been through some ups and some downs. I've been through some tiring things in my life. But God brought me out. You all right? That's a rough time. It wasn't your money. Because one day you're going to run out of money. Maybe you think you look good now, young people. No offense, but get up there to about 60 and 70 and some things are going to change. Am I right about it? Maybe you think it's your education, but one day your mind might lose you. And I'm so glad this morning, I told you about my young age, I'm so glad this morning that I can wake up with my mind stayed on
of Jesus. I know I can't prove it, but I know there is a God. I have the evidence that he walks with me. I have the evidence that he talks with me. I have the evidence that he tells me I am his own. And young people, you're going to have to find your own evidence. You can't live off mom and daddy's evidence for so long. You can't live off the church evidence for so long. Because when you are in school, if you're going to college, if you're going to high school, it's going to be a moment in your life where you're going to have your own experience and your own evidence. Young people that think you know everything, and you have not had any real life experiences yet. Well, let me take that back. Some of y'all have. I will say that. Some of you all have. But you still, the Bible says in verse 5 that submit yourselves to the elders. We live in a time where we forget the old. We live in a time where we forget where we've come from. Everything is geared towards the youth and all the excitement. And I agree with you. I'm on the same page with you. You know, y'all got a lot of energy. But when you don't have life experiences, you ought to listen to the elders. You ought to listen to the old. You ought to listen to your teachers when you go to school. When you don't listen, sometimes your road just gets a little rougher. It just gets harder. And the Bible says that you young people must humble yourselves. Young people, humility is difficult. I get it. Being humble is difficult. Amen? But it's so becoming. It's so respectful. You can be a senior right now in high school, but remember when you was a freshman? You remember when you was a freshman, you walked through the doors? You can be in eighth grade now, but then you remember when you was in fifth grade and sixth grade? You don't remember that? Potter, you don't remember that? You're a senior? What a senior is that? Marky? Okay. You remember when you walked through them doors your freshman year? But you still have to humble yourself. Don't forget where you came from. Don't forget where you used to be, you know? I was watching Kentucky basketball the other day, and they're in the Bahamas right now. And Coach Calipari, he has all of these number one recruits. If you know basketball, Coach K in Kentucky, that's like NBA University almost. And, you know, but he has all of his players wash all of those young people's feet in the Bahamas. That's not an amen moment. I know that's not an amen moment. But what I'm trying to point is that all of these people that's all the way up here in their athletics and they're on TV and they're doing all these great things, he pulled them down when they went to the Bahamas. They thought they were just playing basketball, but he pulled them all the way down and snatched them from their, you know, you get snatched back down from that high horse. And he says, wash these young people's feet that are not as fortunate as you. Don't ever get so high that you can't get snatched down. That's what my daddy told me. I'll snatch you in public. No matter who you are, where you are, I can snatch you. I can get you wherever I can. Because you're not too big enough where I can't snatch your butt down. 10 years ago, Deacon Samilton, oldest Samilton, he told me, these young people is watching you. He pulled me to a side and had a good conversation with me. And at that time, I thought I was up here. And he told me, this is a true story, I was wearing my earrings to church every Sunday. You know, because, you know, I feel like I wear my earrings, I can do what I want, you know. He pulled me aside and said, these young people watching you, and I want you to take your earrings out. That's what he told me, Rev. He said, I want you to take your earrings out. He probably don't remember that, but that was over 10 years ago now. I'm 24 years old. I'm grown. But he says, I want you to take your earrings out. And guess what? Next Sunday,
They was out. I was mad, but they was out. That's because I respect him as my elder. And when an elder asks you to do something, that means do it quickly, willingly, and without question. That was a rough moment for me. That was a rough time for me because I thought I was so high. I'm 24 years old. I went home to Chicago a couple weeks ago and I still got to get up and take out the trash, and I'm 35 years old. But it's in my parents' house. And that means I still have to follow their directions. So when you come to church, young people, and not just the young people, check your egos at the door. You're not in charge here. This ain't your church. Check your egos at the door. Submit yourselves to the elders. And when you resist, that's a sign of disrespect a little bit. And the scripture says God opposes the proud, but he gives grace to the humble. So that means you have to humble yourselves. Don't push the elders away, young people. Don't do that. You're not big enough. You ain't strong enough. Too many of these elders have stepped in the back room, sat in the back room for you. Some of these elders have been beaten by slapjacks. Some of these elders have walked miles and miles just to get you to go to school and to vote and do everything that you want to do. Respect these elders and treat them with the utmost respect. You can be on an all-state, all-city team all you want. You can have a 4.2 all you want. Everybody know your name all you want, but you still got to have some RES. So that means you got to pull your pants up. I went to the bank the other day. It's 3 o'clock in the afternoon, and I see a young person with pajamas on. I'm trying to give them the benefit of the doubt. Maybe they just got off work. I don't know. But at 3 o'clock in the morning, 3 o'clock in the afternoon, you got pajamas on in the bank? Bonnets? Yeah. When the road is rough, the going gets tough, and the hills are hard to climb. Your trials are coming, I promise you they are. Your valleys are coming, I promise you they are. I like it this way. Back in 1972, you know I got an old song, you know I got an old spirit. That inner city blues, help me somebody. Hang ups and letdowns. Bad breaks and setbacks. The natural fact is, okay, I can't pay my taxes. It's gonna be some setbacks in your life. I promise you it is. I wish I had some help. Some of y'all act like y'all listen to gospel all day long. I know the young people don't listen to a gospel all day. They probably don't even listen to it at all. They looking at me like, I don't listen to gospel. Yeah, I get it. But I found out in verse 6 that God has his hands on you. God has his hands on you. His hands is always on the children. The text said, in due time, he will exalt you. In due time. In due time. God will exalt you. Young people, look around you. Take a look on the outside. Just real quick. I'm going to ask him a question here in a little bit. Take a look on the outside. Actually, you know what? Stand up. Y'all young people, stand up. Turn around. I'm about to ask these elders and these saints a question. If you've ever been through some rough times, raise your hand. If you ever, the lights is blinking back there. If you ever really been through some hard times, raise the other hand. You see that? All right, take a seat. Take a seat. Now you know why I asked them to raise one hand and the other? You know why? Because when you lift up both hands, not only is the praise there, but the surrender is there as well. When you lift up both of your hands and you surrender and submit and praise and worship, you better lift up both your hands and know that God is still able exceedingly and abundantly more than you will ever imagine. It's hard, young people, to give up what you like when God is trying to love on you. Can I be transparent? I love my sinful ways, but the Lord is trying to get me to another place. I ain't the only one. That's a wave up both of your hands right there, too. But I want to tell you, young people, that you need to struggle. You need to go through some things. You need to go through some rough times. If you ain't gone through some rough times, then you ain't got nowhere to go. Now, if you haven't struggled, you really can't shout right here. You really can't praise right here. Every time I desire to do good, evil is always present. Now, put yourself in there. Every time you desire to do good, evil is always present. And evil, I don't want to do it exactly, but I sometimes... I'm just trying to be open and transparent. You know, sometimes you got to go through to get through. Some of y'all going to hit rock bottom, but I guarantee you, you'll find out that he's the rock at the bottom. I need some elders. I need some people that's sinned. I need some sinners in the house. Is there any sinners in the house that's gonna wave up both your hands? I need some people that knows that God can draw a line with a crooked stick. Hey, I need some people that I know that God can draw a line, a straight line with a crooked stick. Are there any crooks in the house? Are there any crooked people in the house? Some decisions you wish you didn't make? Some skeletons in your closet? You need to be honest and know that it was rough for you. Tell these young people that you know what cognac tastes like. Can I come down your road this morning? Tell these young people what gin tastes like. Tell them what Cavassier tastes like. Tell them you know what weed tastes like and feel like and smell like. Can I get some witnesses in the house this morning? But guess what? God still lets you come to church. God still lets you teach school. God still lets you teach Sunday school. God still lets you direct the choir. God still lets you be on the praise and worship team. God still lets you usher on the usher board. God still. God still covers all of your mess. Even during your rough times, God still covers all of your mess. Now here's an opportunity for everybody. This is an opportunity for everybody. Everybody look down your row. And I guarantee you're going to find a sinner. Now, if you ain't got no road, look behind you. And I guarantee you're going to find a sinner.
What I like about looking down your row is, don't look too far past your seat. Even with your dressed up self this Sunday morning, even with all your best gear on this morning, I come to tell you that the stain is still there, but God still covered your mess during your rough times. And I'm glad this morning. I thank God for forgiveness. Because if everybody knew your entire story, they probably wouldn't want to sit on your row. Some of them might want to move right now if they knew your entire story. I'm talking about everything. When you was 15 and 16, when you was 20 and 21, when you was 30 and 40, when you was 50 and 60, when you 70 and 80, God still has the strength to cover your mess during your rough times. Some of y'all might be sitting alone next week. You might not have nobody sitting on your row next week. But even if they don't sit on your row next week, guess what? God still cares for you. Young people, God still cares for you. God still loves you. And that's what I want you to understand. You're going to have some rough times this semester. You're going to have some trying times this year. Listen, you're going to have some rough times this year. It's not going to be easy. But you got some witnesses out here. You got some experiences out here that can teach you some things, but you got to open yourself up. You got to open up your heart. I'm glad this morning. Because if it had not been for the Lord on my side, I love those old songs. You know, Amazing Grace, How Sweet the Sound, Through Many Dangers, Tars and Snares, We Have Already Come. The song says, "Twas, twas, twas, not my friends, not my job, not my spouse, not my career, not my friends, not my job, not my career, but it was grace that brought me this far." I'm still searching out this word grace, because sometimes we take advantage of it. We think it's just supposed to be there. It don't work like that. But God still...
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Now, I'm... Verse 7, it says that God will take care of you. He has his hands on you. And that word care means anxiety, which means to be pulled in all kind of directions, young people. Pulled and stretched out in all type of directions. Rough times in your life will pull you in all kind of directions. Young people, all kind of stuff is on your mind. I know it is. I work with young people, and so I know that trouble is on your hearts and all throughout life. You're traveling, you're going down the street. You can't even walk down the street these days without something happening. You're going through some rough times. You're going to have school here in a little bit. You're going to have some homework. You're going to have, Miss Asbury, you're going to have some homework? I know Miss Asbury going to have some homework. You're going to have some papers to write. You're going to have some tests. You're going to have some quizzes. You're going to have some girlfriends. You're going to have some boyfriends. You're going to have some parents that get on your nerves. You're going to have some siblings that get on your nerve. I know I'm talking to you. I know I am. I know I am. You're going to have some coaches that get on your nerves. You're going to have some teammates that get on your nerves. You're going to have some social network things that's getting on your nerves. I know you got, for some of y'all, I'm going to be open. Some of y'all got sex on your mind. I know it. Hey, y'all looking at me. I'm just saying what you got on your mind. You're going to have some health issues. You're going to have some rough times in your life. And for my seniors and my people that's out here, my parents, you're going to have bills on your mind. You're going to have your children on your mind. Tuition is on your mind. Hello. Sometimes you ain't going to have no food. The car might not start. The air conditioner might not work. You're going to go through some rough times in your life, but anxieties, God still has his hand on you. And you're going to see your neighbors, some of them don't even go to church, but they got a new car. They got new things. You're going to go to school and they're going to have new clothes and they don't even go to school.
Yeah. That's right.
But on today, here's what I like you to do, what the Bible says in verse 7. I want you to cast your cares. I want you to cast your cares. You can throw it out there. You can shoot it out there. You can volleyball it out there. You can do whatever you want to do. But I want you to cast your cares, which means to place everything on Jesus. Amen. Some of y'all missed that. I want you to cast all your cares on Jesus. Throw them out there. Throw them out there. This is important. And I know y'all listen to music, and I'm here to tell you this morning, it's not Kiki, Do You Love Me? Are you riding? Say you'll never leave from beside me. All these challenges. These people doing challenges and then get hit by stuff. I mean, that don't make no sense. All this, that don't make no sense. But what I do like, I agree with you on this. I do like Drake's God's Plan. I do like that. I do like that, you know, because in there it says, trying to keep me peaceful is a struggle for me. Is that right, young people? And so you just have to know that even during your rough times, there is some material, some music out there that will help you through those rough times. It ain't always got to be in a hymn book. It ain't always got to be there. So I want y'all to understand, I'm in that category with y'all. I mean, I can get in there with y'all. I love all types of music. But for those that don't know what I'm talking about, some of y'all didn't catch some of them songs. Some of them songs kind of went over your head. That's a song that goes, "What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege it is to carry everything to God in prayer." So this morning, put it on Jesus, amen? Put all your troubles on Jesus. Put all your rough times on Jesus. You're going to have some worries, but cast it on Jesus. It's a rough time, rough moment in your life, but cast it on Jesus. You have a number of things to be worried about this morning. I agree with you, but I'm here this morning to tell you to cast all of that on Jesus. God has his hands on you. God has his hands on you. God cares for you. God loves you. God cares for you. Some of y'all missed the cue. Some of y'all ain't got it yet. With all of the mess that you're in right now, some of y'all got some late fees, some overdraft fees, some bills, some drugs, some things that you're going through. some papers and essays that you're about to have to go through in your life, but guess what? God still cares for you. God cares about one thing. 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 Guess what it is? You. He cares about you. 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 God cares about you, so hug yourself. Love on yourself. Encourage yourself. Motivate yourself and know that God cares about cares about you. Pass me not, O gentle Savior. Hear my humble cry. While on others that are calling, do not. God cares about you. Do not pass me by. He walks with me. He talks with me. And he tells me I am his own. He cares for me. He loves me. Love on yourself. Pat yourself on the back. Take care of your own self. And when you don't care about yourself, guess what? He cares about. Even when you gave up on yourself, he cares about you. I'm going to say this and I'll be done. I have this old spirit in my body because I hung out with my grandmama quite a bit. I love her, bless her soul. She's no longer here. She gave me a lot of fits. But all the fits now fit in my life. She didn't have a degree. She barely went to high school. She didn't never had no driver's license because everybody used to come and pick her up. She had a TV. She had to turn the knob on the TV. And she only had three channels. The news, the Cubs game, and the Price is Right. Nowadays, y'all got so many channels. Y'all got so many things. You got Netflix, you got this, you got that. You can stream from your phone. I had to get up and turn the TV with some old pliers when I was at my grandma's house. She had a radio every now and then, and every now and then she would have some music on. It wasn't always gospel. It was some blues, it was some R&B, some little jazz here and there. But on Thursdays, I would go visit my grandmama, and that's when I knew if she was gonna go to church or not. How did I know if she was gonna go to church? Because she would already have her clothes. She already, it's Thursday, Granny. Why you already got your clothes out? She getting ready. She getting ready for Sunday. You got three more days, but. Why you got your clothes already out? You got your stockings all out. You got your slip out. Y'all don't wear it, I know y'all. Am I coming down your road this morning? And I would say, Granny, why you got all your stuff out? She just say, you know, I'm just getting ready. I'm getting prepared for Sunday. And I'm like, Granny, but it's Thursday. But she said, baby, you know, I'm old now, and I don't got a lot of time on Sundays to get myself ready. So now I got to wait on Thursday to get myself ready. But then every now and then, she'll have a song on by Mahalia Jackson. It took me a little while to understand this old song. And I said earlier, I don't always like going to church. I don't always like hearing these old songs, but I remember an old song that kind of goes like this. Be not dismayed. Whatever betide you, you need to know God will. Beneath his wings of love abides you. You need to know that God will take care of you. Through days of toil, when your heart does not, when your heart fails, when danger fierce, your path assail. You better remember that God will take care of you. How many of y'all know that song? How many of that brings memories to y'all? God will take care of you. Every minute of your life, not another second, not another minute, not an hour, God will take care of you. Because you know why? He cares for you. He cares for you. How many of y'all believe that in y'all these black and green shirts? How many of y'all, no, I'm serious. How many of y'all believe, truly believe that God will take care of you? I got the evidence that God will take care of you. God will take care of you. We extend the privilege of the church. Thank you.
going to work in your favor. Late in the midnight hour, God's going to turn around. He's going to work in your favor. Late in the midnight hour, God's going to turn around. He's going to work in your favor.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
We have